So good evening everybody. I will be starting my class today. So the topic today will be electric organs in fishes. So let us see what I'll
Evening,
start
sir.
sliding sharing my slides or my screen. As we know that electric organs are present in many fishes, and they are present in both chondrichthyes as well as in ostrichthyes, and they are capable of generating electric currents. So basically they are of two types. One, those who possess large electric organs and they produce a strong electric current, and those who produce a weak electric discharge. Most of these fishes are freshwater fishes, but there are some marine fishes also. They are freshwater fishes, most of them. So these are among the most important examples which you people I will recommend you to study are, first is the torpedo and electrophorus. So this the torpedo has got one pair of electric organ, and they release electric current of 60 volt, and they are marine. The electrophorus has got three pairs, and they release something like 350 to 550 volts. They are rivers of South America they are found in. So these are the most two important fishes which sort of have give electric currents, basically protection and other defense and other means. So the structure of the electric organs. So each organ, the basic structure is that it has got specialized muscle cells known as electrocytes. They are the special cells. These cells have lost the ability to contract like muscle cells, but they are modified to generate current. They can generate current. They are arranged in stacks or in a series, like batteries in a torchlight. You have one cell, after that another cell, another cell. So like a battery. So they release an electric current in this direction. So they are embedded in a jelly-like extracellular materials and are bound together by connective tissue into a compartment. So each cell, it is a multinucleate. They have got many nucleus in that cell with nearly transparent cytoplasm. So the cytoplasm is transparent. The cytoplasm is transparent and multinucleate. Interesting thing is that one cell surface is rough, raised into papillae or folds, and the other is smooth. That is, on one side you have got papillae or folds like this, and the other side of the cell is smooth. This is the basic structure of electrocyte. So one side is folded into papillae and one side is smooth. So this is the specialty of this. And the smooth surface is supplied with nerves. So if you see this cell like this, you have nerve connections on the smooth side. This side does not have any nerve connections, the rough side. The the mode of contact between the nerves and the electrocyte may vary in different species. Species to species, it differs. In torpedo, the nerves branch repeatedly and extend over the entire surface of the electrocyte. That is, if this is the smooth surface, the nerves, they branch. Extensively like this in torpedo, and this is the rough side. This is the rough side, so they branch extensively like that. So let us look at the electric organ of torpedo. Just hold on, somebody is trying to enter. So, this is the torpedo, and these are the electric organs which are located in this region. Essentially, this is the structure of the electric organ here. You have got little stacks of cells organized like batteries. They are organized like batteries in this region. So, as we know, torpedo is a marine fish, and they produce torpedo. They have got, each fish has two large and two small sized organs on each side of the body. The main organ is in the form of a large kidney shaped mass. So it's in the shape of a kidney, it's like a kidney. And they are supplied with thick branches of the 8th, 9th, and 10th cranial nerves. Each organ is composed of 45 vertical hexagonal columns, each having 400 electrocytes.
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Kichu koran nei. I'll send the video recording. So, each organ is composed of 45 vertical hexagonal columns, each having 400 electrocytes. So as I told that there is a large organ, and inside that there is another small organ. So the smaller organ lies within the larger one. The innervative side of the electrocyte is electrically negative to the other side, and all work together in parallel. These fish are capable of paralyzing a fast swimming prey, the prey is moving, say for example the prey is moving, and immediately the torpedo is over here, it releases an electric current and this prey is paralyzed above them by electric current before capturing them. The current passes from the dorsal side to the ventral side. The electric discharge varies from 30 volts to in torpedo, and is up 30 to 60 volts in torpedo, and up to 220 volt in narcine. Sometimes it can go as high as 1000 watts, good enough to kill you. 440 volts will kill you. So this is quite a strong electric current. So now let us look at the case in electric eel. Electrophorus electricus, that's the electric eel. It has a snake-like 2-meter long body A pair of electric organs is present on each side of the body, one of which is much larger than in size than the other. Okay. The smaller organ on the ventral side is called the Hunter's organ. So let us have a look at the photo. So what, where is the electric organ located? See, this is the electric organ. The one below is known as Hunter's organ. So you have taken a cross section. A cross section. So the electric eel is go like this. You take a cross section from here. And you see, this is the vertebral column, the muscles or the myotomes located here. So this is the Hunter's organ. And it is the on the long side, you see that it's located in this manner. So this is how it looks. So these are the electric organs. Now let us go to, there are other electric organs in different fishes. I will send this thing, you can look at that. And then you have the weak electric fishes. Just two, three examples. Just two to three examples. Need to remember two to three examples. So these are the weak electric fishes. Next, we come to the origin of the electric organ. In torpedo, the electric organ, it is derived from branchial muscles near the gills, and they have lost their original functions. So they are basically, they were muscle cells, and they lost their functions. And the function was near the gill arches. They used to move the gill arches, and they have lost it, and they become into the muscle cells have converted into electric organs. In the electric eel, they have developed from the lateral muscles of the body in the electric eel. Just I would recommend you people to study about Electrophorus, the electric eel, and torpedo. Studying both of this will be good enough. So the mechanism of electric discharge. Now have a look at, first have a look at how the cells are. So one side is smooth, this side is smooth, this side is rough. As if you remember, nerve impulse, inside is negative, outside is positive. And the potential difference in nerve cells, you have read that to be minus 70 millivolts. In this case, in these cells, it is minus 100 millivolts. You know, sodium is always higher on the outside and lower on the inside. And it is, let's see, somebody is trying to enter. Who is trying to enter? Okay. তোমরা কি স্ক্রিনটা দেখতে পাচ্ছিলে? হ্যালো, আচ্ছা, ভেরি গুড। কেন হঠাৎ আমি দেখলাম আমাকে আবার স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করতে হলো, স্ক্রিন শেয়ারিংটা ছিল না। ওকে, স্ক্রিনটা তাহলে দেখতে পাচ্ছ? তাহলে ওকে, এখন দেখতে পাচ্ছ ইলেকট্রোসাইটটাকে? ওকে, ভয়েস ব্রেক কিছু করা যাবে না, দ্যাট ইজ নেটওয়ার্ক প্রবলেম। ইউ উইল হ্যাভ দ্য রেকর্ডিং, ইউ ক্যান ওয়্যার ইউ কুড নট হিয়ার, ইউ ক্যান রি লিসেন টু ইট মেনি টাইমস। আই উইল আপলোড ইট অন ইউটিউব, ইউ ক্যান লিসেন টু ইট অ্যাজ মেনি টাইমস অ্যাজ ইউ ওয়ান্ট, স্লোলি, ফাস্ট, ইউ ক্যান স্কিপ, ডু হোয়াট এভার উইথ ইট ইউ ওয়ান্ট। সো As you know that inside is 100 millivolts and outside inside is negative and outside is positive, and you know that the sodium ion concentration outside it is higher than that in inside, and potassium concentration is higher inside and outside it is less. So, and you also know one thing which I had mentioned, that it is innervated by many nerve fibers. So, you have in torpedo, you have many nerve fibers. So, when a stimulus comes, the animal wants to release an electric current from its brain, the 8th, 9th, and 10th, the famous three cranial nerves. They will send an impulse and they will stimulate this cell. The moment they will stimulate these cells, what will happen? Like in nerve impulse, the channels will open and immediately potassium star sodium will start entering inside. And from minus 100, deep like it happens in nerve cells, depolarization will happen. A process known as depolarization. Depolarization. Known as depolarization will happen. A process known as depolarization. When depolarization happens, then inside becomes plus 60 volts, from minus 100 to plus 60 volt. Another interesting thing which happens is that only the depolarization happens in the smooth region. In the rough region, there is no depolarization. So, within the cell, there becomes a potential difference of 150 volts, 150 millivolts within the cell. One cell, there is a difference. One side is this, one side it is depolarized, and this side it is not depolarized. Result is that from one end of this cell, from here to here, the difference is 150 millivolts difference. Because if this potential difference exists, what happens is that an electric current will flow in the on the top of the cell. Like when if water is poured from the top, it will fall on the bottom. Similarly, electric current will move from a higher potential to a lower potential. So there is a huge potential difference within one cell itself. So current will start flowing. And now if you have a series of cells, one after the other, like a battery, you have a huge electric current flowing from one direction to the other. And this, if so, this is released in the water, and it can paralyze a prey, or if anybody touches it, it gets a shock, because there's a huge electric current which will flow. So this is how the electric current flows. As you can see in this picture, as I explained, it is drawn over here, the same thing. You see, one electrocyte is, this is the first electrocyte, second electrocyte, third electrocyte. All of them are attached by a nerve. A depolarization takes place. Half the cell is polarized, half is not polarized. Result, one electric current will flow from here, one electric current will flow from here, one electric current will flow from here, and it will hit outside very fast. And as you see, there are 400 of them. When it comes, this will amplify into a very strong current. Khub jor shock lagbe. So this is how the electric current moves. This is what I've explained. So this is the head region, tail region. The electric current moves like this. The ions move as it is. So what are the functions of the electric organs? So functions of electric organs, they differ with form, position, and the strength of the current produced. Species having powerful electric organs use them for both offense and defense. The prey is paralyzed as a result of the discharge, and is then eaten, of course. The primary function of the electric organ in all species may be to provide protection against attack from predator. In the electric catfish Malapterus and Narcin, they use the capability to discharge a strong current mainly for defense. Species having weak electric organs like the Mormyrids use the electric organs for detecting objects or enemies in the surrounding or water by electrolocation. So they with mild current and changes in the charges, they can locate what is there in the surroundings. Almost like instead of sound, they are releasing electric currents, weak electric currents. So weak that we cannot even feel it. But they can understand that there is a change in the electric field. There, it's the electric field is getting disrupted by maybe an object which is an insulator. Weak electric current is also used by the fish for electrocommunication. Like sound communication among whales, you have electric communication for social purpose. Every species has a special pattern of electric field around its body and is able to use this for recognition of members of its own species and sex recognition. So looking at the electric current signature around your body, even you also have an electric current, static and electrostatic charges around you. So with this special electric field, you can easily understand you cannot understand, but this organism can understand, okay, that belongs to my species, that has got a different electric current signature, that's a different species. Maybe they are blind, so they use this electric current for recognition. They also help the fish in finding direction in the dark and muddy waters. So weak electric discharge is also for showing territoriality. So there are many functions of this electric current. So with this, I would like to end my class today. I'm stopping my sharing now. And very soon I will be within 1 or 2 days, I will take your next chapter. I will be talking about your next chapter. So I will end my class over here. Do you have any questions? Those who are unable to listen to this, I will send the link in the group. You can watch the video, make your questions and ask me. Jodi question thake, please ask me. Anybody has questions? Okay, nobody has got questions. Ache?
Sir.
Haan.
Sir, mujhe ekta jinish bolar chilo.
Haan, bolo.
Second semester e je ki minor elective paper ta ache, to seta to amader kono class ba kichu hoyni. To jodi kichu mane notes ba important
PD sir contact PD sir ke jiggesh koro. PD sir er kache thakbe ota. ঠিক আছে, নাথিং টু ওয়ারি, কন্ট্যাক্ট পিডি স্যার, হি উইল এক্সপ্লেন মানে হোয়াট ইজ নিডেড। ঠিক আছে, নাথিং টু ওয়ারি অ্যাবাউট, চিন্তা করার কিছুই নেই। সো উই হ্যাভ টু ফলো হোয়াট কেএনইউ সেজ, বেসিক্যালি উই আর নট হিরোজ অর চ্যাম্পিয়ন্স, উই আর সিম্পল টিচার্স হু আর টেকিং ক্লাসেস অ্যান্ড ইউ পিপল রেজিং ফিঙ্গার্স অন আস, দ্যাট ইজ ভেরি রং। এনিওয়ে I end my class over here. I will inform you of my next class.